usual 8 set boosters, as you can see there. And I can turn that gently because of the dice, but as you can see on the back, we get the usual land packs, 8 set boosters, a giant spin down die, and the storage box. But what makes this bundle unique is that you actually get 4 promo cards rather than 1. Let's start by opening the box. I'm going to try and do this as quietly as I can. So I can guarantee getting the 1 card that I need. It's quite a nice bit of text on the top there, I like that. And we get the usual small poster as well. So that looks like it's some sort of end artwork. And on the other side, my name is growing all the time, and I've lived a very long, long time, so my name is like a story. That's okay artwork, I like that. So let's lift the lid. You also get the artwork of the ring there in the fires of Mount Doom. Recycling that wizards like to include in all their bundle products. We've got artwork of Sauron there, and I'm guessing that's Arwen, but I could be wrong. But yeah, do like the Lord of the Rings style planeswalker symbol there. That's quite nice. Oh, you do get some unique ring counters as well, rather than just +1/+1. +1/+1 on the other side, yeah. Oh, and there's also a Sauron style as well. Was not aware of that. This is the dice. It's got a very elvish design to it, and like a green white tint. It's funny because on the back of the box it shows a white dice, but I've only ever seen people open green ones. But this one does actually have a strong hint of white in part of it, and parts of it. So maybe it's meant to be a mixture, but still, it's pretty cool. And the number 20 is actually a picture of the ring. So I'll put that down to one side. We've got your typical reference cards there. Promo pack, which I'll open in a bit. And we've also got 8 set boosters. I'm just going to refocus the camera there so it's a bit more aligned. Right. Let's zoom in, I think. Okay, welcome back. Just zoomed in a bit so we can see the cards a bit better. So here's the promo pack. I'm just going to open it up. for one white mana, you get a 1/2 halfling citizen. You may pay a hybrid or Zoth of 2. And if Frodo is a citizen, he becomes a halfling scout with base power 2, 3, and lifelink. And then you may pay 3 black mana. And if Frodo is a scout, it becomes a halfling rogue with whenever this creature deals combat damage to a player, that player loses the game if the ring has tempted you 4 or more times this game. Otherwise, the ring tempts you. And then we have Samwise, the Stout-Hearted. And 1 and a white for a 2/1 halfling peasant with flash. When he enters the battlefield, choose up to 1 target opponent card in your graveyard that was put there from the battlefield this turn. Return it to your hand, and then the ring tempts you. We've got Gollum, Patient Plotter, which for 1 and a black, you get a 3/1 halfling horror. When he leaves the battlefield, the ring tempts you, and you may pay 1 and sacrifice a creature to return Gollum from your graveyard to your hand. Activate only as a sorcery. And then the card that you're really into for this bundle is the One Ring. For 4 mana, you get an artifact that's indestructible. When the One Ring enters the battlefield, if you cast it, you gain protection from everything until your next turn. And at the beginning of your upkeep, you lose 1 life for each bird encounter on the One Ring. And then you can tap it to put a bird encounter on the One Ring, then draw a card for each bird encounter on the One Ring. So these cards also make up a large piece of artwork as well. So if we do that, which I don't think I'm going to get on camera, but you can kind of see that all the pictures match up to make one giant scene from The Lord of the Rings. Easterling Vanguard, Haradrim Spearmaster, Eomer of the Ridermark, Erkinbrand, Lord of Westhold, or Westfold even, sorry, Prince Imeral the Fair. That's a little bit of a hit, not a massive hit, but it's definitely a useful card. And then we've got Samwise Gamgee, green and a white for a 2/2 halfling peasant. Whenever another non-token creature enters the battlefield under your control, create a food token and sacrifice 3 food. Return target historic card from your graveyard to your hand. Elvish Mariner, 2 and a blue for a 3/2 elf pilot. Whenever Elvish Mariner attacks, scry 1, and whenever you scry, tap up to X, target non-land permanents, where X is the number of cards looked at while scrying this way. Then we got Press the Enemy, 2 and 2 blue for an instant. Return target, spell, or non-land permanent an opponent controls to its owner's hand. You may cast an instant or sorcery spell with equal or lesser value from your hand without
its mana cost. And then we got another copy of Samwise the Sourhearted. That's just the regular art. And an Orc army token as well, because armies are back in this set. So let's go on to pack two. +1/+1 counter on Bane of Progress for each permanent destroyed this way. halfling knight with haste. Has first strike as long as it's equipped. And whenever you attack with Merry and another legendary creature, draw a card. And then we've also got Landrove or Horizon Witness. Spells from among those cards for as long as they remain exiled, and mana of any type can be spent to cast them. And then we've got Eomer, Marshal of Rohan, 2/2 red for a 4/4 human knight with haste. Whenever one or more other attacking legendary creatures you control die, untap all creatures you control. After this phase, there's an additional combat phase. This ability triggers only once each turn. And then we've also got a foil Rosy Cotton there. Two packs to go. So far I've only had one mythic as well, I'm pretty sure, so instead create two of those tokens that adapt to an attacking, and the equipped cost is 2. And then there's Banish from Edoras. And then we've got another list card here, Segovian Angel. So, one pack to go. So, luckily, you get that really expensive promo card. Otherwise, this box would have been an absolute buster. But, let's see what we get in the last pack. So, an art card. A basic forest. Soldier of the Grey Host. Eagles of the North. Escape from Orthanc. Isolation at Orthanc. Stone of Eric. The Bath Song. The Grey Havens. Glorfindel Dauntless Rescuer. Dunland Sir Crebane. For a 3/3 human soldier with vigilance. Whenever an opponent casts a spell, if no mana was spent to cast it, counter that spell. And then you can sacrifice Boromir, whom creatures you control gain indestructible until end of turn, and the ring tempts you. And then at the very end, we've got a foil Gothmog. So, there we have him. So that's evidence that you really shouldn't spend a lot of money on these boxes. The hype for this set is unreal, but I don't actually think the value is justified in the price. There we go. I've been Foamy ASMR. Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, please like and subscribe. It really helps the channel grow. And if you leave a comment below, I'll get back to you. I'll see you in.